in support of international advocacy for West Papua. Over the weekend, 21 members of the West Papua National Committee, or KNPB, were arrested by police in Yakubiro Regency as they distributed leaflets about the planned peaceful rally to be held today. KNPB Chairman Victor Yemo says the rally is to show support for the Pacific countries who are members of the Pacific Islands Coalition on West Papua. The Russian President Vladimir Putin has tightened his grip on power, with his party United Russia winning a decisive victory in nationwide parliamentary election. BBC Sarah Rainsford reports. Vladimir Putin called this a vote for stability. His critics say it shows many Russians have simply lost faith in parliament. The Governing Party, United Russia, has won overwhelmingly, despite his downturn in the economy. And the same four parties that are broadly loyal to the president have been returned to power. Generally, opposition parties can nowhere near. But Turner this time is on course to beat the new server. And reports of cheating have also been flooding the internet. Regional falters, Darwin, Lamotte, New Guinea Islands, isolated showers and possible thunderstorms. Islands, isolated showers, then areas of morning fog. And turn the news to main points again. Papua New Guinean implicated in the illegal purchase of property in Australia. Dolphins demand answers from provincial government and more arrests in Indonesia's Papua region. That has been the NBC PNG regional news.
Our main stories, a crime-free independent celebrations in Bougainville, successful celebrations, and ABG leaders complete computer course. The news in detail. The Bougainville Police Service, BPS, has reported a peaceful Papua New Guinea's 41st independent celebrations over the weekend in North Bougainville. The BPS told NBC News today that it was a crime-free celebration with no when launching a trial agriculture on Fiji, they are under tension in Ward 7 of the Chapter of the King and Zainala Breakfast. Jason Jim O'Brien reports. And the Williamson Energy District Development Authority within recognizing its potential has given priority to the agriculture as well as at the launch of the demo project. Mr. Sam stressed that lack of knowledge was respecting the people in terms of logistical things among other related issues. He said English potential to have onion and really making crops a farmer to start on this demo project, however, stressed the logistical challenges having limited the number of crops of a row. Agriculture Mr. Michael Antwai also welcomed similar sentiments, adding that sustained farming in Goa had a huge potential economically when transport was a challenge. Mr. Antwai will be acquiring English potatoes from fresh produce development agency in Western Highlands and Bob Onion and other seeds from agriculture input suppliers like Brian Bell and Thompson. This is from the NBC Clarifications, Fort Moresby.
And finally tonight, the New Island Province supporting from Business College, Cornwall Campus, has been renamed as the Cayman School of Business, Tourism and Hospitality Studies. The name change commemorates the 10th anniversary of the school's establishment in the province. The college works at the J's with courses on campus as well as on professional centers, following a partnership MOA signed in 2003. 10 years on, and the college has moved to a new location, with the name now localized as the 5th of the Cayman School of Business, Tourism and Hospitality Studies. Governor Sir Julius Chen unveiled the name change as one of the leaders for both speaking values.
A good number of people send us this year to the women's program to participate in the 10th anniversary celebration. Present at the meeting were members of the governing council, lecturers and head of departments, and the college principal, John August, Ukraine has a first week to join the local staff and students. New Ireland Governor Sir Julius Chen was also present. British government team also present were at a TVET institution in the province, St. Diana Cortez Vocational, St. Joseph and any level vocational system. Speaking of the Kenton College principals were over safe, their even campuses made small but significant changes over the past 10 years.
So can you finish this table here? Quickly grow, quickly grow, quickly working, but it is significant. MOU we will sign in 8th of September 2006. We pay creating this agreement, call it formal agreement, play of faith, and it is this. Conservative operation will stop 10 years, and we start to spend 10 years or more. It's been a long, hard road, but it has been worth it. Seeing students graduating and continuing on with their education is the most satisfying thing. We are a government institution, and college was created by the main campus, which is Concord Moses Business College in Mosby. We advise on behalf of all my New Ireland to take advantage of this opportunity. It will not grow yet, but we will grow in terms of curriculum.
That was the business college principal, John August, running the task and the current issues, even.
That's how we begin the week on PM Conversation. If you've got any feedback, you can contact the NBC newsroom on 325-1990, 323-4540, and 323-5968. The email address is news@nbc.com.pg. On behalf of the team, I'm Jerry Sabin. Have a pleasant evening. Good night.
In Australia, Downfield, among the uncles from the provincial government, and the government in the Indonesian region. The Australian Task Force investigation has identified a Papua New Guinean who illegally purchased a property in Townsville. The Papua New Guinean is among violent from Taiwan, Chinese, United States, and Singapore, that purchased illegally homes in Southfield.